Hello friends, welcome back. This is the second lecture on worm gears. In this lecture, we will deal with proportions of worm gears. And here we solve one numerical based on terminology and proportions of worm gears. Proportions of worm gears. First of all, everyone carefully observe the figure which is shown on the screen. In screen clearly show the worm and worm wheel. The basic dimension of worm and worm wheel that is shown in figure. First of all, everyone observe the worm. First of all, everyone observe the dimension of worm. And remember one thing, suffix 1 is used for worm and suffix 2 is used for worm wheel. D1, pitch circle diameter of worm. DA1, outside diameter of worm. DF1, root diameter of worm. HA1, addendum. HF1, dedendum. P suffix X, axial pitch. Gamma, lead angle. These are the dimensions of worm. Again, let me observe the dimensions of worm wheel. D2, pitch circle diameter of worm wheel. DA2, throat diameter of worm wheel. DF2, root diameter of worm wheel. HA2, addendum at throat. HF2, dedendum in median plane. These are the dimensions of worm wheel. Now let me find out the dimensions one by one. First of all, we find out the dimensions of worm. For an involute helicoid tooth profile, HA1, that is addendum of worm, HA1 is equal to module. Consider equation 1. HF1, dedendum of worm, HF1 is equal to inside the bracket 2.2 cos gamma minus 1 bracket complete into module. Consider equation 2. Using this expression, we get the value of dedendum of worm. Clearance small c is equal to 0.2 into module into cos gamma. Consider equation number 3, where HA1 addendum in millimeter, HF1 dedendum in millimeter, and small c clearance in millimeter. The outside and root diameter of the worm are expressed as follows. Again, everyone observe the sketch of worm. First time that outside diameter DA1, how to get the value of outside diameter of DA1? DA1 is equal to D1 plus 2 times addendum of worm. DA1 is equal to D1 plus 2 HA1. Here we know the value of DA1, pitch circle diameter of a worm, and D1, pitch circle diameter of a worm, and HA1, addendum of a worm, that is the value of addendum expressed in equation number 1. Now here we have to substitute the value of D1 and HA1 in that relation. D1, diametral quotient into module, product of diametral quotient and module, and the addendum of a worm, that is equal to the module. That's why DA1 is equal to QM plus 2 times module. From that, from this equation, we take a module common, and finally we get a outside diameter of a worm. DA1 is equal to module inside the bracket Q plus 2 bracket complete. Consider equation number 4. Similarly, again everyone observe the figure of worm, and using this sketch, we find out the root diameter of worm, that denoted by letter DF2. DF2 is equal to D1 minus 2 HF1. HF1, that is dididendum, the value of dididendum present in equation number 2, and this value we have to substitute in that relation. DF1 is equal to QM minus 2 into inside the bracket 2.2 cos gamma minus 1. Simplify this relation and we get a root diameter of worm. DF1 is equal to M into inside the bracket Q plus 2 minus 4.4 cos gamma, bracket complete. Consider equation number 5, where DA1 is equal to outside diameter of worm in millimeter, DF2 is equal to root diameter of worm in millimeter. Now let me find the dimensions of a worm wheel. Similarly, the dimensions of worm wheel can be expressed. The dimension, the addendum and dididendum of the worm wheel are expressed at the throat. Now observe the addendum of worm wheel. DA2 is equal to M into inside the bracket 2 cos gamma minus 1, bracket complete. Consider equation number 6. Dididendum HF2 is equal to M inside the bracket 1 plus 0.2 cos gamma, bracket complete. Consider equation number 7, where HA2 is equal to addendum at the throat in millimeter, HF2 is equal to dididendum in the median plane in millimeter. Now the throat and root diameter of worm wheel express as follows. First of all, we find out the throat diameter DA2. Everyone observe the sketch carefully. Using the sketch, we get the value of a throat diameter of worm wheel. DA2 is equal to D2 plus 2 times addendum of worm wheel. DA2 is equal to D2 plus 2 HA2. Now we know the value of D2 and HA2. The value of HA2, that is present in equation number 6. Pitch circle diameter of worm wheel is known to you, M into Z. And DA2 is equal to MZ2 plus 2M into inside the bracket 2 cos gamma minus 1. From this relation, we take a module common. And finally, we get a throat diameter of a worm wheel. DA2 is equal to M into inside the bracket Z2 plus 4 cos gamma minus 2. Consider equation number 8. Similarly, we obtain the value of a root diameter of worm wheel. Again, observe the sketch carefully. DF2 is equal to D2 minus 2 HF2. HF2, dididendum of worm wheel, and the value of that dididendum that is expressed in equation number 7. This value we have to substitute in that relation. DF2 is equal to MZ2 minus 2M into inside the bracket 1 plus 0.2 cos gamma, bracket complete. Simplify this bracket. And after simplification, we get the root diameter of worm wheel. DF2 is equal to module into inside the bracket Z2 minus 2 minus 0.4 cos gamma, bracket complete. Consider equation number 9, where DA2 is equal to throat diameter of worm wheel in millimeter and DF2 is equal to root diameter of worm wheel in millimeter. Again, two important dimensions of a worm wheel, that is the effective face width and length of root of worm wheel teeth. These two dimensions are very important in case of a worm wheel. Effective face width of the worm wheel, that denoted by letter capital F. And so another dimension, the length of root of worm wheel teeth, that denoted by letter small L suffix R. LR, that notation is used to denote the length of root of worm wheel teeth. Okay. Again, everyone observe this sketch carefully. The effective face width F, capital F, of the worm wheel is shown in figure. It is obtained by drawing a tangent AB to the pitch circle diameter of the worm. A and B are the point of intersection of this tangent and the outside diameter of the worm, that is clearly shown in figure. Okay, now from figure we consider a triangle AOC. AOC is the right angle triangle, and for that triangle we have to use the relation AC square is equal to AO square minus OC square. Observe the sketch carefully. We know the value of AC, AO and OC. That is clearly shown in figure. AC F by 2 bracket square is equal to AO DA1 by 2 bracket square minus OC D1 by 2 bracket square. Now here in that relation we have to substitute the value of TA1 outside diameter of worm and D1 is the pitch circle diameter of worm. Okay, now here we have to substitute outside diameter of worm inside the bracket m into q m into inside the bracket q plus 2 bracket complete divided by 2 bracket rest to 2 minus d1 q m divided by 2 bracket square. Simplify this relation and we get the effective face width of worm bill. Capital F is equal to 2m into mistakenly plus sign is present there. The plus sign is completely wrong. Multiplication sign is present. Multiplication sign is considered there. Effective face width of a worm wheel, capital F is equal to 2m into under root q plus 1. Consider equation number 20. This expression is very important. Effective face width of worm wheel. Again, everyone observe the sketch carefully. From this sketch, we consider a triangle OZC1. OZC1. In that triangle, we consider a sine delta. Sine, we know the relation for sine. Sine, that is front side to the hypotenuse. Front side is C1Z divided by hypotenuse is OZ. And from figure, the value of C1Z is clearly mentioned and also the value of OZ is clearly mentioned. We have to substitute the value of C1Z and OZ in that relation. Sine delta is equal to F by 2 divided by DA1 plus 2C divided by 2. 2 to get cancelled and we get a delta is equal to sine inverse into inside the bracket F divided by DA1 plus 2C. F is the effective face width of worm wheel. DA1 is the outside diameter of worm. C is the clearance in worm. Remember this. Okay. That expression is very important. Now next thing. This thing is very important. The length of root of worm wheel teeth is the arc XYZ. That is again clearly shown in this figure. The length of root of worm wheel teeth is the arc XYZ, which is denoted by LR, small l suffix small r. LR, that notation is used to express the length of root of worm wheel teeth. LR is equal to arc XYZ. Arc XYZ is equal to inside the bracket 2 delta divided by 2 pi into again inside the bracket pi into inside the bracket DA1 plus 2C bracket complete. And after simplification we get the relation DA1 plus 2C into delta. The value of delta, which is already calculated, the value of delta we have to substitute in that relation and we get the value of LR is equal to DA1 plus 2C into sine inverse inside the bracket F divided by DA1 plus 2C. Consider equation number 21. Equation 20 and 21 is very important for the dimensions of worm wheel. Equation 20, F is the effective face width of worm wheel and equation 21, LR, length of root of worm wheel teeth. Okay, everyone remember these relations. When we that relations are very important when we solve a problem, a numerical based on that. This is the whole tooth proportions for worm gears. Now let me solve one problem based on terminology and proportions of worm gears. Everyone carefully read this problem statement. A pair of worm gears is designated as 1/30/10/8. Now everyone know how to designate the worm gears, a pair of worm gears. That was already discussed in a terminology of worm gears. Z1/Z2/Q/M. Okay. Calculate number 1 the center distance, number 2 the speed reduction, number 3 the dimensions of worm, and number 4 the dimensions of worm wheel. Okay, first of all we collect the given data. Given data, just a designation of worm gears. Z1 is equal to 1 means Z1 is the number of starts. Z1 is equal to 1 means that screw having a single start threads. 30, Z2 is equal to 30, number of teeth on a worm wheel is 30. 10, diametral quotient, Q is equal to 10. 8, module of worm wheel, M is equal to 8 millimeter. This is the given data. Now, here we determine the first point, the center distance. Step number first, center distance. We know the relation for center distance. In case of a worm gears, A is equal to M by 2 into inside the bracket Q plus Z2. We know all the values, substitute all the values in that relation. 8 by 2 into Q 10 plus Z2 is 30. Simplify that and we get a center distance between worm and worm wheel. A is equal to 160 millimeter. Consider equation 1. Number 2, step number 2, second point that will be solved in step number 2, speed reduction that denoted by letter small I is equal to Z2 divided by Z1, Z2 is the number of teeth on a worm wheel and Z1 is the number of starts on a worm. Number of teeth is 30, number of teeth on a worm wheel is 30 and number of starts on a worm is 1, 30 divided by 1 and we get a speed reduction ratio I is equal to 30. Consider equation 2. Now the third point that is solved in step third, dimensions of worm. Now here we determine the dimensions of worm. We already discussed the proportions of worm gears. In that we discussed the dimensions of worm. D1 pitch circle diameter of worm, DA1 outside diameter of worm, DF1 root diameter of worm, PX axial pitch of worm. These are the dimensions of worm. Now let me solve one by one. First, pitch circle diameter of worm, D1 is equal to Q into M, Q 10 into 8 is equal to 80 millimeter. Consider equation A. Next, outside diameter of worm. Outside diameter denoted by letter DA1. We know the relation for DA1. DA1 is equal to module into inside the bracket Q plus 2. Module 8 into inside the bracket 10 plus 2. Simplify that. We get the outside diameter of worm 96 millimeter. Consider equation B. For obtaining the root diameter, we need a lead angle of worm. That's why first of all here we find out the lead angle. Tan gamma is equal to Z1 by Q. Now this relation we already discussed in terminology of worm gear. Tan gamma is equal to Z1 by Q. Z1 is the number of starts. Q is the diametral quotient. 1 divided by 10. Take a tan inverse. Gamma. Then we obtain the value of lead angle gamma is equal to 5.71 degree. After that we find out the root diameter of worm. DF1, we know the relation for root diameter of worm. DF1 is equal to module into inside the bracket Q plus 2 minus 4.4 cos gamma. Now in that relation mistakenly point get missed, that is considered 4.4, it is not considered 44. Okay, now here we have to substitute the values in that relation. 8 into inside the bracket 10 plus 2 minus 4.4 cos 5.71. Simplify that and we get a value of root diameter of worm 60.9747 millimeter. Consider equation number C. And the last dimension of worm, axial pitch. P suffix x is equal to pi into m. That is the relation to obtain the value of axial pitch. Pi into 8. We get the value of axial pitch P suffix x is equal to 25.1327 millimeter. Consider equation number D. And the last bit, dimensions of a worm wheel. Here we know the dimensions of worm wheel, which was already discussed in the proportions of worm gear. D2 is the pitch circle diameter of a worm wheel. DA2 is the throat diameter of worm wheel, and DF2 is the root diameter of worm wheel. Now let me find one by one. Pitch circle diameter of worm wheel, D2 is equal to M into Z2, 8 into 30, and we get the value of a pitch circle diameter of worm wheel, D2 is equal to 240 millimeter. Consider equation A. Next, throat diameter of worm wheel. Throat diameter denoted by letter DA2, and we know the relation for throat diameter of worm wheel, DA2 is equal to M into inside the bracket Z2 plus 4 cos gamma minus 2, bracket complete. Now in that relation we have to substitute the values, known values. 8 into inside the bracket 30 plus 4 cos gamma 5.71 degree minus 2. Simplify that and we get a throat diameter of worm wheel 255.8412 millimeter. Consider equation number B. And the final dimension of worm wheel, root diameter of worm wheel, that denoted by letter DF2, and DF2 is obtained by the relation M into inside the bracket Z2 minus 2 minus 0.4 cos gamma, bracket complete. In that relation again we have to substitute the values of known parameter. 8 into inside the bracket 30 minus 2 minus 0.4 cos gamma 5.71. Simplify that and we get the root diameter of worm wheel, DF2 is equal to 220.8159 millimeter. Consider equation number C. This is the whole problem which is asked on terminology and tooth proportion. This problem is asked for 5 to 6 marks in university examination. Thank you very much.